What's up, you guys? I'm outside and I decided to come behind this background and I think it looks really cool. Comment below, let me know if you like it. I like the color and the vibrancy, but today I have a fun video for you. I'm sharing 3 tips how to get you to stop flaking on your fitness, how to be consistent and finally make this a part of your life. So before I get started, I want to thank our sponsor, Lucid Mattress. They sent us 2 mattresses for the boys, twin size foam mattresses. And they are so comfortable, so easy to set up. It came in a box. You could just like, you cut it open with this little tool they give you. It's so easy to set up and it is super duper comfortable. So we have been loving these mattresses. James and I are even talking about maybe getting it when we're ready to replace ours. We don't have a foam mattress, but it's so comfy. The boys are loving it. Liam even wanted a little more plush of a mattress. So we ordered the foam topper to make it extra plush, comfy and soft. And he loves it. The boys are like sleeping in their beds, not coming in at 4 a.m. anymore. So if you're looking to get a new mattress, check out Lucid Mattress. I thought their company was amazing. We love the product. I have a coupon code for 40% off, Lily40. It'll be in the description box below, so check that out. Okay, guys, so I'm excited about this because these are real life practical tips, not just fluff. Have you ever started a fitness journey? You're all good. You're like, yes, I'm working out for a week, and then life happens and you just get off of your routine. Well, today I got my nifty list and I'm gonna show you how to master this and stop flaking on your fitness once and for all so that you can get these guns, right? All right, so the first one and probably the most important to me is plan your workouts in motion. What does that mean? Your workouts, your likelihood of staying consistent and doing your workouts is if you plan them when you're already in motion, meaning dropping your kid off, already have your clothes on. Right after that drop off, you're gonna go do your workout. You're gonna go to the gym. You're gonna pull over and, you know, go to a park and walk. You have to be in motion. Your success rate and chances of sticking to this when you're already in motion is much greater. Once you get home, it is over, you guys. So if you don't wanna wake up early, and that is something that keeps like bringing you down, you like wake up early for a week and then you stop, then maybe try right after work, have your workout clothes on, and do not go home until you did your workout. And I know sometimes, guys, it's a sacrifice. You wanna get home, you wanna rest already, but if you really wanna reach your goals, let's say if you just wanna lose weight, if you wanna feel your best, you have to figure out a way. So my top, like the way that has helped me out the most is by doing it already in motion. I drop my sons off to school, and I just pull up my laptop. I'm able to just do my workouts from my laptop right there to school. I bring weights, I have Wi-Fi, and I do it right there. I know some of you may not feel confident enough to do that. I don't care. No one's watching. I'm in a secluded area and I get it in and I feel amazing. All right, tip number 2, start off just doing something fun. If sometimes people like start their fitness regimen and they go in hard, like a hard program, a hard workout, that they just get exhausted and burnt out, do something that you actually like to do. And it could even be kayaking, paddle boarding. It could be just going for like a speed walk outside at a park. Something that you can genuinely say like, I enjoy doing this. Do that consistently for at least 2 to 3 weeks and then move on to something a little bit more hardcore. But sometimes people flake out on their fitness because they go in too hard, they get sore, and then they just end up giving up. So start off fun, do that consistently for 3 to 4 weeks, and then move on. And you know, you're gonna have your whole life to do this, okay? Tip number 3, and probably another important one, which is why it's part of this video, is change your mindset. Once you get out of that like diet mentality, like I call it diet versus lifestyle mentality. Once you get out of that mentality, that this is something like it's a drag, like it's a burden to work out. Once you change your mindset and you understand that working out is something, is a gift you give yourself. Not only is it something amazing for like mental clarity, mental health, you're gonna feel your best, look your best, but this is something you wanna do for the rest of your life so that you can grow old strong and not like this brittle, like aches and pains and just like taking all this medication. Don't you wanna be happy and healthy and vibrant? That's how I picture like my maturing age, like just my older years. I don't want to be a cripply old lady. Now is the time, guys, to set that foundation. Stop looking at your fitness as an end date with an end date, and think of it more of something that you are going to do for the rest of your life to feel your best. So, all right, guys, those are my three little tips. Comment below. I want to hear which ones were your favorites out of the ones I mentioned. So plan your workouts in motion. Start off with something fun. Do that consistently and then work your way up. And then number three, what is it? Change your outlook. Change your outlook. Don't look at it as a chore, as a burden. Look at it as your recipe, your formula for living a healthy, active life of just vitality, just like, you know, happiness, and just like living your best life. And like always, if you need help getting started, you feel clueless, you know you want to do something but you don't know how to get started, I'll have my email in the description box below. I always have challenge groups running every month, and I'd be happy to help you and show you the way. Bye, guys.